Windy City Poker Championship is produced by Fallah Productions Inc. and is owned by Windy City Poker Championship Inc. For more information, call 708-935-2861.
Hey, Kirk, what's going on? I thought we were tracking a show today.
I'm a little busy right now, Jason. We got a little game going. If I win, I get to host his show for a day. If he wins, he's going to track the winner to golf with you. So, you know, there's four spades out there, but I'm just going to go all in. I don't think you got it right now, Dave.
I look forward to working with you, Dave.
Stop sweating the table, Jason.
You know what? I watch a lot of the Windy City Poker Championships, and I watch you play.
Okay.
You bluff way too much, my
friend. Not right now, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Sure about that?
God bless it.
You know what? I call.
I got a five.
It's a nice hand for you, Gert.
All right.
Let's go do a poker show.
Let's get to work, Catman.
Go have some fun, buddy.
It's the Windy City Poker Championship. I'm all in it to win it. The Rock Life, baby. 48.
I love the Rock Life.
Well, here we go, poker fans. Another stellar tournament brought to you by Windy City Poker Championship, with a lineup of known pros and tough amateurs playing in a winner-take-all format. Nine players, $1,500 a man. One person will walk away with it all, and the rest will walk away with nothing. Thanks to the poker skills, or lack thereof, of executive producer and former co-host Kirk Fallah, I'm joined in the booth today by national radio and television personality and Chicago native David the Catman Kaplan. Without further ado, let's hit the felt.
And at this time, shuffle up and deal.
Well, Dave, it's great to have you here in the booth with me. I'm looking forward to watching this table with you.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm a huge poker fan, and you know, some really good players here. My buddy Richard Roper with his Chicago Police Memorial Foundation hat, and of course, world champion Jerry Yang and Mark Kroon. So it should be a lot of fun to watch these guys. Well, Richard just looks like a pro. Looks like he knows what he's doing.
He does. He spent a little bit of time at the TV table and a lot of time at charity events around Chicago. A charitable guy, and we appreciate him coming out for this one as well.
Poker is just such a popular thing. It's great TV, but it's just such a mind-numbing experience. You get there and you think you know what you're doing until you sit down and you go, uh-oh, I'm a little bit confused, but I think guys are really excited after waiting for a few hours, back ready to go.
Well, I know Kevin Boyd is excited. He's opened up here with an ace-nine offsuit. Just got back from the hotel, taking a shower and getting a workout in after his main event run.
What kind of a workout that would be? Treadmill, weightlifting, or maybe just 12-ounce curls?
I'm guessing total body experience just by looking at him.
Exactly right.
Well, your buddy Richard Roper makes the call with king-queen of diamonds.
That's a strong hand. King-queen diamonds is a very, very solid hand. See if he can hit something on the flop.
Raise 400, he said.
He said.
And a little bit of clarification here. We've got a $500 total raise. Yeah.
Okay. That's what he said. We don't know what he implied.
That's okay. Everybody interprets my bets differently.
Is that ambiguity on purpose?
It can be part of the illusion. Why not?
Jack 8-6, three suits. Everybody misses.
Check.
See if Kevin can put a little bit more aggression back into the hand here. And it looks like he is reaching for chips. He's making a delayed continuation bet, as we call it.
Who calls it the delayed continuation bet? Let us inside your world.
I'm not sure how to answer that, Dave. Good question.
All right, anytime you win the first hand, you have to show it, though.
What is that, three jacks?
Okay. Those are the rules?
Yeah, those are the rules.
Yeah,
we
agreed on that. Just
okay.
The amateur getting razzed a little bit. Gives a little free information. Yeah, shows everybody the ace.
I'll show that next time.
And he'll take down the first hand of this winner-take-all tournament. All right, well, our winner-take-all participants start with 15,000 in chips. Line levels are 20 minutes, and we've got a nice gradual structure here. These guys get a little bit of room to play.
Which means you'll see some aggression early because you want to build up a little bit of a cushion for those later hands. The blinds start to increase, and you want to have a chance to maybe deal with a couple of setbacks.
I think that's right. I think some of these players are definitely going to come out aggressive early. We might see a couple of them hang back. Remember, there's no prize for second place.
Whoever knocks me out gets a $215.
They love to talk their bounty talk.
I'm sure they're just kidding.
Oh, yeah, just like the NFL guys when they take somebody's head off on a kickoff.
Well, Scotty is going to open this pot. He puts in a raise to 300 with ace-jack unsuited.
Gary interested in the conversation more than in the poker. It's funny, some guys love the conversation, others want to put the headphones on and say, leave me alone, I don't want to hear you.
Well, Gary is a police officer. Maybe he was listening for any sort of talk of no good at the table.
Call.
See if somebody can hit something on the flop, and 397 says no.
Nope, another whiff. Although Kevin does have a gut shot, and he is thinking about that at the moment.
Okay.
If Ted was willing to limp along the first time, there is no way if Scotty Clark fires out a bet here. I just don't think you can continue to hang around with nothing.
Well, he does fire out a bet of 650, and it looks like Ted is thinking about it. Ted does have position on Scotty. He might be thinking about floating him here and trying to take it away later.
I think that's the Red Bull speaking.
Well, the turn is a seven of diamonds, pairs the board.
There is no way Ted could stay around again if Scotty fires out, and he's going to fire big.
You're absolutely right. 1,750, a big bet into this pot. Ted's still thinking about it.
Don't even wipe your eyes, Ted. Lay the cards down.
Well, we know who Dave is rooting for.
My man, Richard Roper.
That's it. The cards go bye-bye.
Good decision, Ted. Had to lay that down.
And Scotty shows a jack of clubs. Scotty Clark, everybody.
Ho, the kid that you beat in the first round?
Yeah.
We're talking about it. And at some point, he says, gosh, I ain't never played with a guy who talked that much. That's what he said. I go, was it distracting? He goes,
about Mark?
Hell yes. That's what he said. That was his version of it.
You're restricting it to never played with a guy that talked that much or never met?
Right.
I think he got to him a little bit with that stuff, you know. He said it was distracting.
Well, you guys are way too good at
Jerry,
fall for
was
that
he talking stuff. A lot in your heads up match?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. Were you responding?
I tried.
Yeah, he responded with a bluff and then I'd fall.
Yeah,
he'd
did.
Stack your chips.
I wish I had brought my earphones though. Wish I had brought my earphones.
They're talking about the heads up match that he and Jerry played earlier in our poker
and then
series.
Right after I won, Phil Hellmuth texts me.
Yeah.
I'm not kidding.
And then he texts me, he goes, you lost to Jerry Yang, heads up. And then, yeah, and then he goes, for a poker player, you should take up golf. That kind of hurt me that he would take off.
That's your friend.
Yeah, that's my boy. The funny thing is, that morning I did a radio show with Annie Duke, who beat Jerry in the heads up, NBC heads up. And so she gave me a lot of tips.
Right.
And not one of them helped. none of them stopped Jerry from hitting his one outer on me, or three outer, or four outer, or whatever it was.
Well, I never did think he played as good as Annie, Mark.
Could you just tell a semi-bad beat story on TV?
No, I don't believe in bad beat stories. But Jerry did beat Phil Ivey heads up, so I feel like maybe I'm in the same category as Phil Ivey now because Jerry beat us both.
Some roundabout way.
Seems fair.
Yeah. Good luck with that 600 raising.
Mr. Robo gave me a lot of hard time doing the heads up match.
Did you beat Jerry?
Well, if I beat him, how would you have then played him? Yes, I did, but I told him to go ahead.
Go ahead. Just go beat the hole for me.
They announced that Richard won. Yeah.
I made that mistake. I actually told the man with the mic wrong.
For TV, you know. We had fun for about 2 hours.
Wasn't there a point of that heads-up match between you two where, like, Jerry had, like, eight big blinds and you were down to three somewhere in that range area? It was pretty... I mean, it was an epic battle for sure.
It was a long match. I think probably the longest match, I think.
Oh, without a doubt. Without a doubt.
Did you win the match after my match?
No, I lost.
Oh, did you?
I lost to Jason.
Two local guys.
We'd beaten him up so much by then.
Yeah,
the other guy just
Jerry down.
He
didn't
like
feel like a champion after we got him.
And fishy, Dave Backstrom's going to take down this hand.
Hey, show one of those.
Should I?
You have to. Yeah. You just got bluffed, sir.
Now that we're all starting to enjoy ourselves, we're going to make you watch a commercial. We'll be right back.
We want to thank you, Chicagoland, for over 50 years of loyalty.
And we'd love to add you to our family of over 200,000 satisfied customers. If you're in the market for a great quality garage, take a look at this.
Call Danley's and we'll build your new garage with free wreck and haul of your old garage. Or take $1,500 off a new garage. Quality work, quality service. That's Danley's Garage World.
Danley's 773. 773-